So I didn't want to, you know, lose my virginity so fast. And it was kind of the Catholic Church's fault. Like, now, I'm cool with Jesus. I knew Jesus didn't mind if I had sex because Jesus loved whores, right? It's in the Bible. He hung out with prostitutes. They were his favorite people. Whenever he was getting fed up with the apostles, he'd be like, where are my prostitutes? And they'd be like, we're here. And he'd be like, oh, we're not going to be able to write about you in the Bible, but cool. And then he was friends with them. So I knew that once I had sex, I would just confess to Jesus. I had sex, and he'd be like, you know, I love that. And I'd be like, I know, just telling you. And so that would be fine. What I was afraid of was getting pregnant. Obviously, I didn't want to be a teenage mother or a mother, period. So I knew if I got pregnant, I would have to have an abortion. And I was very afraid of abortion because of church. Not because of Jesus, but because of the priests at church. Every single sermon the priests at my church did were about abortion, even though it was not in the Bible that day. You know, they would be like, Merry Christmas, everybody. And we are here because Mary had a baby. She kept it, even though she didn't know who the fuck gave it to her. And we will celebrate Mary. She didn't have an abortion like you girls who go to the clubs and use it as birth control. And then if you had an abortion, you're going to hell. If you know someone that's had an abortion, you're going to hell. You're all going to hell. Guys, don't worry about you. We'll high five you. It's cool. You got a woman pregnant. But the women are going to hell. And I was like, I don't want to go to hell. I don't want to go to hell. So I decided I'm never going to get pregnant. And the easiest way to do that is just to never have sex. And I really didn't understand what an abortion was. I didn't know it was a safe medical procedure that prevents a pregnancy from becoming a pregnancy. I thought you carried a baby to full term, and then quietly in a doctor's office, they like shot it in the head. You know, I was like, I'm not doing that. Not judging, but I'm not doing that. So instead of sex, I was the girl who loved being fingered. I love fingering. I still love it. I love fingering. I am bringing back fingering. It's amazing. Do it to everybody. It's not just for kids. It's like sugar cereal. Adults can enjoy it too. It's wonderful. You're going right to the source. It's the greatest feeling on earth. And so I had a lovely boyfriend who used to finger me. And the first time I ever got fingered, oh my God. I mean, I touched myself before, but when you get to go hands-free, it's like, whee, it's so exciting. And the feeling was so powerful that after I got fingered, every moment after that I wasn't getting fingered, I was in a deep, dark depression. And that's why when you see goth girls walking around, they're not trying to get attention, they're upset. They got fingered once and haven't been fingered since. And they're like, it's all so dark, everything is horrible, I don't feel anything. So anyway, my boyfriend usually went first on me because he was a good guy. But this one time I wanted to return the favor. And so I took my two dry hands and I rubbed his penis up and down like you do. And it almost caught on fire. And so like a skilled firefighter, he grabbed it like a hose and was like, I got this. And he came on his hand like a young man of 17 does. And he wiped it on his t-shirt in the basement. And then he kindly went in to return the favor. But all I saw on that finger, well, I couldn't see it, but I knew it was there, billions and billions of sperm. And I didn't want to be like, can you wash your hands? I'm not ready to become a mother, because that's dorky, right? And then I was like, wait a minute, you can't get pregnant from fingering. They would have told us, right? They would have told us that in school. Unless they don't know what this is, and we just invented it. But I was like, I need that good feeling, so I let it happen. No consequences. I didn't care. I woke up in the middle of the night, and I just put my hand on my stomach and I felt a heartbeat and I was like, oh my God, I'm a mother. I was so dumb. I didn't know that you could feel a pulse anywhere else but your wrist. That was the first time I had noticed a pulse anywhere else in my body. And I thought I'd grown a baby in 4 hours. I was like, woo, that happens fast. No wonder this abortion is such a hot topic. There's a living, breathing person in there.